Friends, greetings once again from the New York International Auto Show. I told you we were going to pick up and look at some more cars, but today we have a very, very special live broadcast. Our old friend Bradley Arnold is back, and this is falls under the heading of I told you so. Do you guys remember what was it, 6 years ago?
Yes. Yeah, probably six.
Six years ago when this kid, you know, he barely was out of high school. He started drawing cars.
It's not true at all.
And I found out from his wife that on his profile, he said for his occupation, I draw cars. No joke.
That's true.
That's how he met his wife. But now
well, it didn't help.
It did. Well, it did help.
Yeah.
She wouldn't have looked at you otherwise.
That's true. Yeah.
Anyway, he designed, or was, you had the sketch that won the interior of the Hyundai curb concept,
yeah.
Which, if you go back many years ago, we did a build. You and I literally built the concept car from start to finish.
Yep.
So that was Brad's design. Brad was a big part of that episode. Well, of course, since then, Brad had left Hyundai, went to General Motors, designed concept Cadillacs, but then he missed me.
That's
so
right.
He came back to Hyundai.
True.
And
main reason, exactly. Yeah.
And he's also a teacher at Art Center.
That's true.
But look what he designed just for the New York Auto Show. Let me turn this around on you. And what do we have here?
So we have the GV80 concept SUV. So first SUV concept for Genesis vehicles.
Yeah. SUV concept. So this is the Genesis brand.
Yeah.
And so tell me a little bit about what this is supposed to be.
So the GV80 concept is important for us, being that it's our first
And let's
SUV.
Walk around, like, yeah. Let's look at it.
It's also the first opportunity for us to unveil a lot of key characteristics that will be part of Genesis form language moving forward. Mainly as you look at the front, the quad lamp, that light signature will be on Genesis vehicles moving forward. Our crest-shaped grille is going to be an icon.
So that's a bit of an evolution from the current G80 and G90, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. And what's interesting about the way we've executed on this car specifically, so this crest-shaped grille will be part of Genesis vehicles moving forward, but on this vehicle, we were thinking about the crest-shaped grille and the shape of it being reminiscent of a diamond.
Yeah.
So in profile, it's kind of reminiscent of a diamond shape.
Okay.
And we gave that diamond, what does every diamond need? It needs a setting, right?
So it needs a grille.
So we gave that diamond its setting. And what you see down here in this lower grille shape is kind of graphically a three-prong setting for this diamond, which adds the protection and the importance for something of value, right? And this is our piece of value on the face of this car.
Wow.
So
now, refresh the audience. Tell them the process. Like, you and I know what goes on behind the scenes on how a concept car or even a real car comes to pass.
Right.
There's like a design competition. So explain to me what happened internally for your sketch to become this.
Actually, for this vehicle is a little bit different. We had been working on another concept, another design for this concept that was really, you want me to follow you?
Follow me a bit, yeah. They want to see the car as you're talking.
So
you're lovely, but not that lovely.
That's right, that's right. This is the important part.
Yeah.
She's a lot prettier than I am.
Yeah.
So for this vehicle, we had one concept car going, one design direction going, and I was actually sketching on myself and another designer, Tony Chen, were sketching on the production version of this vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
And just a few of the sketches clicked, and it was a different approach to what we were already executing in the studio. So they ended up taking our sketches and asking us to do the show car version of it. So
now that's pretty backwards, isn't it?
It's
usually the concept and then the show, the production car.
And Tony continued on working on the production version of the vehicle while I went off and executed the show car. So the good thing is that they were being done in concert with one another. So
mm-hmm.
The good side of that is that we were taking influence off of the production car and moving it back and forth between the show car and the production car. And then also, we're already currently working on the production car, which looks a lot like this and takes a lot of cues from this vehicle. So a lot of what we developed in the concept car will be on the production car. So, yeah.
Okay. So show me some, like, we've talked about, like, in the Hyundai, remember how, not the Hyundai, the curb, remember how there was some unique design language that was in the actual structure of the car? Tell me about some of the design language in here.
So our design language for Genesis is referred to as athletic elegance, yeah? On this vehicle specifically, I set up the elegance in side view with this really proud posture of the parabolic line. So the parabolic line starts...
Like a ski.
Like a what?
Like a ski.
Like a ski?
Yeah, a parabolic ski.
Absolutely, absolutely. So that parabolic line starts right up next to the edge of our crest grille, has a lot of volume and a lot of tension as it comes over the power of the front fender and kisses off the A-pillar, and then shoots very tautly down towards the rear fender. And then the point at which it turns and shoots your eye into the rear fender line and then back towards the front fender line is provides a lot of tension and is reminiscent of an archer as he pulls the string back on the bow. You know that as soon as the archer releases the fingers, right, you know what's going to happen. There's a lot of energy and there's a lot of excitement in that image. So that was what we were trying to kind of evoke in this area of the design, is that tension that the string is under before you release the arrow. And then that kind of shoots your eye back down the body side of the vehicle. And it draws your attention to the really generous fender offset.
I got to tell you, I love how this bows out. Yeah. You're going to laugh at me, but this kind of it's reminiscent of a UR Quattro back in the day.
Yeah.
Remember how the fenders bowed out here? Okay. So two questions. Do you see this coming into production, this much of a pronounced fender?
It'll have to be decreased because the overall width, you're just not going to get as much, as much width, but you'll be surprised. The one trick that we've been playing with this parabolic line to get the fenders to feel very voluminous is that this parabolic line, if you'll notice, is really close to the edge of the DLO.
It is.
So when it is that close to the edge of the DLO, the offset out to your fender edges feels a lot more prominent. Typically, shoulder lines are down on the shoulder of the car, which visually doesn't leave you that much room, right, to create offset.
But how are you going to be able to render that in a real car?
No, this line here I'm talking
about. Okay, I
got not the offset here. Okay. You'll have a little bit more of an offset for production. But no, this line being that close to the edge of the cabin gives you the opportunity to provide a lot of fender offset.
So talk to me about this here. I love this. Volvo did this in a concept a couple of years ago.
Absolutely.
I see you're doing
it
here.
We did it on the A-pillar of the curb as well.
Oh, we did. Excuse me, I did it.
That's right.
Wait.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. I got to turn this around. I'm doing this the wrong way. I'm getting all excited.
That's right.
I invented this concept in 2011.
That's true.
Yeah, I was ahead of the curve.
You don't, with the curb.
With the curb.
Yeah. You don't see
he's
it,
more
but
poetic
we,
than me.
We put a credit to MotoMan. It's somewhere. It's in.
Yeah, where is it? Where is the credit?
It's in some one of those.
Okay.
Ones. Yeah. So, I said,
can this make production?
You know what's funny? We are talking more and more because this is really one of the pieces that when everyone sees this show car, people zero in on both the wheels and here. I think it's just a texture and an activity in areas that you don't normally get that. That people are attracted to, so definitely the wheels will make it to production. You can see something like that in production for sure. The pillars we'll have to work on, but I think there's an argument to be made.
When you say the wheels and for sure, that's pretty certain.
That shape, I think, is definitely doable.
But even with this, what would you call it, like a tessellation or a...
Yeah, I believe we're calling it the G matrix is what we've coined it.
The G matrix?
G matrix.
Okay, yeah. G matrix. You heard it from the man himself.
But a lot of these shapes and then the tessellating, polygon surfacing throughout the rocker and the front intake, a lot of that inspiration on the details in all aspects, all areas of the vehicle, was taken from the jewel and the diamond. So we started at the front of the vehicle, the shape of the crest grille.
So the theme is repeated, because we did that, and in all seriousness, we did this kind of thing where we repeated the theme in the curb, and I've seen it in other, over there, that theme. Of that D pillar and the spoiler, it's kind of a theme that goes throughout the whole car.
Yep, the floating aspect, yeah. Yeah, we wanted the details to very precisely and technically contrast.
Oh, it's even repeated. Look at that. It's on the front of the dash as well as on the rearview mirror.
Absolutely, yeah.
That's pretty wild. Now, let me ask you, I learned a lot.
Yeah.
I can't thank you enough for being in the studio with me, or let me be in the studio.
Yeah.
And what I didn't realize is, what's the difference between something that's set by, like, where's John? John, come here. Here's another guest, another special guest, return guest on the show. This is John Krsteski. But now we got to call him Mr. Krsteski, because since you guys last saw him on the Curb project, he runs the Genesis Design Studio. He's the big boss now.
Big boss. There you go.
Congratulations.
Thanks, bud.
You're the man. Seriously, this is two of, like, these guys, I'm going to embarrass them a little bit, but serious, this is not just car designers that design cars. They actually teach future car designers. So they do a bit of both. They create what's coming up in the future, but they're also longtime faculty at Art Center. Is that correct?
Well, and John was my teacher.
Oh, I forgot that piece.
Life,
so this is the circle of life.
Yeah,
so you were 20 years you were working at Art Center. Is that it?
Not 20 years, but 10.
10 years at Art Center, but you went to CCS.
That's right. Correct.
Okay, and then you tutored this man.
Correct.
And then you took him into Hyundai when he graduated,
right.
And then you brought him back.
Right.
So you're kind of like the mob.
Once he lost his way for a little bit, but
that's
you
right.
were able to bring him
yeah.
back.
But seriously, think about this. These guys are not only giving you the future of a car, but their work germinates throughout the student, throughout the world.
Yeah,
I think so.
Yeah,
we're
it's pretty
there.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So what I was just, okay, now I'm done embarrassing them. What I was just talking to Brad about was, do you remember in the Curb, like you and Phil was the design director for Hyundai at the time, now back at GM. You guys set the general theme of what you wanted to do
sure.
for that car, but then like Brad had an interpretation of this activity and bicycles and motorcycles, and that led his thought process for the design of the inside of the Curb. What was the remit that you as the studio head came up with, and how did you interpret that on your own?
I mean, for this concept specifically,
this concept
I think
specifically,
overall
yeah.
we knew going into an SUV like this, we wanted to make a bigger statement.
Yeah.
And one of the things we pushed for is, I mean, a lot of the presence and profile that you see in SUVs is highly important. With this car, it wasn't not only the side profile, but the
yeah.
profile in cross-section. And what you'll see here, especially, is the cross-section is vitally important to the design of this car, because we wanted to make sure that the transference of power was made through the flares and then to the ground. So that's one thing that we really pushed for in this car. So you'll see a lot of power at the wheels in this SUV, which I think sets it apart from every other SUV out there.
And so that was set by you, the studio
that was
head,
set
and
by
everybody.
The collective team, the vision
okay.
that we had, you know,
yeah.
had from all
yeah,
of the
designers, they never together. Take credit on by themselves. It's always
yeah.
the team.
It was the team.
So that was the general remit. And then how did you interpret that? Like, what was your inspiration here to come up to make it this the reality?
Yeah, well, they had been working on some, you know, I returned to Genesis probably 8 months ago, and they had already internally been working on some Genesis projects, so I knew what key characteristics were going to be part of the Genesis DNA,
yeah.
and it was nice to come in with a fresh approach and kind of start working on a product line that they had already kind of begun on, and come up with a few sketches. Basically, it started with a rear three-quarter. I did a one rear three-quarter.
Let's go back and look at the back there.
Yeah.
So I can already see that the D-pillar is very different than kind of what's out there now.
Yeah, a lot of volume. It really, everything stems from the marching orders of having vehicles that are athletically elegant, right? And what does that mean to you? For me, on this vehicle, as we talked about earlier, the lines in side view I think are pretty elegant, set up a really proud posture. But the volume that John was referencing, all this section over the fenders gives it the athletic
yeah.
look. So that was really it. And
let's bring in John for a minute again.
Yeah.
So this isn't just design mumbo jumbo. John is a big proponent of fast cars, has owned many fast cars in his life. So this is not just what comes from the top, it's also what he lives and breathes. Anyway, you repeated this light signature back here as well.
Yeah, the quad lamps are our Genesis light signature moving forward. On this vehicle, we position those on the soft core that runs all the way through the vehicle, so they kind of perfectly frame that volume and that tension that runs through the vehicle.
Yeah.
But yeah, on this vehicle, we kept them very linear, very simple in shape. But when they light up, it's a very menacing appearance.
It's awesome. I love the diffuser in the back. That's like straight from a Lotus Elise, which you know is my favorite car.
So the idea is that all these vertical fins would help to dissipate some of the heat. So not unlike
yeah.
either an air-cooled engine or even the cooling fins on like a hard drive in a computer.
Yeah.
So dissipating all the heat off the electric and fuel
yeah.
cell powertrain components.
I'm noticing that, what do you call it, Genesis? What was this for the theme? The Genesis Matrix?
The G Matrix?
Yeah, I see
yeah.
you're repeating it here in the
so
taillight.
It's laser fiber optic, so it's essentially a cord or a string
yeah.
that runs through the geometry of all the different acrylic pieces.
Okay.
But it ends up giving you a really interesting light signature, very geometric and like you said, very reminiscent of the rocker details and the grille details.
Okay, so let's check out the interior, but I think you're great, but I think there's someone far lovelier than you that's going to talk to us, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Karen.
So where is Karen?
Oh, here she is.
Karen? While we're waiting for Karen, let's take a look at the interior here. Thank you for helping us. This is the inside. Wow, look at the way the texture and the trim on this. This is really, check this out. Again, accentuating the width, but you know what? Rather than me tell you about it, it's Karen.
Hey, MotoMan, I'm Karen.
Hello, Karen. Everybody's excited to meet you.
Thank you. Hi, everyone.
So why don't you stand over here by your work.
Sure.
So tell us name, rank, and serial number.
Serial number?
Yeah.
Well, I can talk about a design inspiration for you.
Okay. So, but first, John and Bradley and I go way back. How long have you been with Hyundai Kia Group?
I've been with them for 7 years.
A while.
Yeah, it's a long time.
Why didn't I meet you when I was working in the studio?
I was young and...
They were hiding you from me. That's what it was. Okay, so tell us about what you've got here.
So this interior, original design.
Oh, one more thing. Where did you go to design school?
Art Center.
Oh, of course.
We all John's student.
Yeah, so John dragged you in right from Art Center.
Yeah, John taught us how to sketch.
Okay.
So the original concept is to make the IP very clean and sleek, and it's inspired by the bridge. So it really...
By a bridge. Really?
So coming from the driver's side, all the way to the passenger, really impress the driver and the passenger and enjoy the driving experience.
Okay.
So you can see a very simple line with integrated vent on here and the HVAC.
Oh, so this is a vent?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's very clean.
Yeah.
And the sound bar is underneath here, so everything
May
is
I
get
in there too?
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
touch
let me
everything.
Get in there.
Touch everything.
Okay. Oh, you're allowing me to touch everything.
I also can show
I promise I won't break it.
The UX functional.
Oh, that would be great.
So
you're saying this is the bridge here?
Yeah.
All this.
Right.
I love the texture. This is like a, it's like a herringbone suit almost.
It's a suede material, architecture of suede material. We try not to use the wood on the dashboard.
Didn't you want wood?
Because it's traditional. It's too, you know, everyone
It's too old fogey, huh?
Yeah, we want to make new, you know, it's for the future buyers.
Okay, that's fine.
So this is beautiful material, as you can see.
It is really nice.
Cross-hatching.
But is that what you call cross-hatching?
Yeah,
I call it herringbone. It looks cool. It's very cool.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Okay, and it's somewhat repeated in the wood here.
Okay, tell you about this internal story. We want to make distinguished Korean.
Okay.
Not only just a luxury car, but distinguished Korean. And the one thing I got inspired for this bridge-looking center console is called kayagum. It's a traditional Korean instrument.
Yeah.
The way you play kayagum is like this. And
yeah.
That's how you use it. You swipe it up.
Oh, so this is actually the UX. This is
yeah, it's
the control.
The inlay metal trim, not only just for design, it's also for the function as well.
Oh, wow. See, I was thinking that looks like the... You've ever seen the cargo area of a Jaguar E-Type?
Yes.
How it's got the carpet and then these like runners?
Yeah.
That's what it looks like, but I thought it was just design.
So you can see there's four functions: navigation, entertainment, communication...
Let me get in there. Oh, I see it now.
...and environment.
Okay, now I see what you're saying.
So, okay. So how you play instruments like this, right? And that's how you control it. So you swipe it up and see the...
Oh, look at that.
The navigation pop out. And then you want the entertainment, you swipe it up, entertainment pop up.
Very
so
cool.
So you're the driver, you want navigation. So you swipe it. Oh, if you don't want it, swipe it down.
So let me try that.
Yeah, try it. Right. Just lightly.
Oh, it worked. That's yes. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, everything works. So I'm the passenger, and I'm like, hey, I don't want to look at your navigation. I want to look at entertainment.
Yeah.
So I can just hold this.
So you hold that. Let's do that again.
Well, usage of the wide 22-inch screen.
Very cool.
And when you swipe it down, you go back to the main screen.
And then this, you can do the scroll here and move some stuff around.
Right.
So here's a scroll wheel. So this is kind of what you see in the paradigm today.
Right.
This is the newer paradigm.
Yeah, this is a more newer function we have. And then the temperature, this is the HVAC design above the fan. So if you want the temperature, you press this and you swipe it to control the temperature.
Oh, okay, let's see that again. Do that again.
To control the temperature, go along the
So HVAC. Guys, what Karen is doing, look what she's doing. She's the temperature to control here.
Yeah,
you
hold
just
it.
Go. Just scroll over the vent. That's wild.
It's beautiful, right? It's a very elegant way.
It's elegant, but it's also, you know what?
It's functional.
It's there's tactile feedback.
And easy to use.
Yeah.
Right?
Because you're driving. I always have a problem with this in that, you know, people do these like screens.
Yes.
But you have no feedback, especially when you're controlling a 5,000-pound car.
And
it's not
you
safe.
You only have a stressful lifestyle, and this car is supposed to make you relax, enjoy your
yeah.
your premium design, and the fan speed, same as fan speed. click fan skip speed and go swipe.
Oh, so you hit the button and then you can go all the way across.
Yeah, so
here.
Every function you can control by swiping along the HVAC.
That's wild.
Just lightly.
Yeah, I guess I'm a little heavy-handed with it. And then you've got, I love this, like, bejeweled,
yes.
bezel here.
So we want to make high-tech so everything is screen, and then you can see yeah. the screen kind of flow behind the navigation screen. So
Mark Paul says this is straight out of Star Trek.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's a good compliment, right?
That's a great compliment.
Yeah, I like that, yeah. I love Star Trek.
You're, wait a minute, you're a Trekkie? Trekkies don't normally look like
However, we want to keep the more premium cluster, physical cluster.
Yeah.
That's why we have this physical cluster on top of the screen.
I gotta tell you, I like that.
That's really beautiful.
So many car companies nowadays are just doing the TFT screen and it loses the individuality.
The detail.
There's no, yeah, there's,
it's an expensive watch.
Exactly. There's a, so you don't, you're not from New York, but in New York there's a watch store, a very famous watch store,
called
Tourneau, and their tagline is, about your watch, it's your other face.
Oh, this is about your cluster.
And this is your other face, yeah.
Yeah, so it's about the attention to detail right here.
Yeah.
And then this flowing infinity of screens.
Now I'm noticing that this same, the G matrix that Brad was telling me about, I'm seeing that theme repeated here.
Yeah, we want to make the whole car harmonious. So all the texture you see is inside out.
You know what? I know this will never make production, the wood on the floor, but it's awesome.
It's like really, home away from home.
It's
you're
gorgeous.
Like you're home.
It's really nice. I don't think it'll ever make production, but it's gorgeous.
Yeah,
this
really
I got to tell you, why don't more car companies do this? Because this is such a beautiful design of an airflow vent. Why
right.
wouldn't they?
Well, this is a represent our future production line. So yes, you will see in the near future. And if you want to buy it, just go to Genesis dealership.
I like the shameless promotion. Wow. Karen doesn't fool around. Okay, guys, you got to buy the car. No doubt about it. So
and
what
do you see the beautiful coral king?
Take a look.
Like diamond look.
I don't
want to
break your car. I just hit the wood.
No, crazy. Pro bigger.
Let me get out of the car and show it. Oh, this is the other side. Well, what are you calling this, like, lattice framework here?
Because diamond-looking frame. Diamond, it's inspired by a diamond.
Oh, it wasn't inspired by diamond, it was inspired by me. I did this in the curve. I came up with this idea 6 years ago. You stole this idea from me, Gary.
Sorry.
I'm going to have to sue you for this.
I'll buy you a coffee, Gary.
Okay. Thank
it's
you
okay.
very much. Very nice of you, Gary. Let's take a look out here.
Oh, you can see a lot of
okay, so we're gonna have a tech person open up the door while we're waiting for someone to open up the door. Karen, tell us a little bit more about your background. You're from Taiwan?
Yeah, I'm from Taiwan. I'm very excited to be part of the Genesis team.
You should. This is awesome.
Oh my god, so amazing.
Yeah.
So exciting.
Okay.
I want to cry when I see they present this car on the stage.
Is this your first sketch that got to production or
no,
even a
show car?
First show car. Has any of your work made it to production car?
Yes, I'm the lead designer for Sonata interior.
Really?
Yes.
The new one?
The last generation.
John has been hiding you from me. I don't know what's going on here. I'm very bad mad at John.
And also the new Azera in Korea.
Oh,
it's Grunger.
Oh, yeah.
The American called Azera. So I'm the lead interior designer for that.
So you have a lot of interior work behind you.
Production
background.
Yeah.
Isn't it usually the other way around? You get more concept work?
You know, I always thought doing a show car would be easier, but
yeah.
to me, this is my most challenging project. And
okay.
it's great team where you work with a color and train, exterior designer. You have to make sure every design language comes inside and out, and
yeah.
the flow inside.
While we're waiting for them to open that door, let's go to the back here. There's Brad. Brad, can you get the back door open for us?
I don't. We have to find the...
Yeah, you get on that. That's Brad's job. There's Brad. Okay, what's
so
going on back here?
Beautiful.
Was the fitted luggage your idea?
Yeah, so this two is check-in, and this one you can carry on. Look at that. Yeah,
wow. Oh, seriously? That's pretty
yeah.
cool.
And then the sway, the architecture sway on the dashboard.
Oh, so this is repeated from the dash.
Yes,
look at this, guys. The same, the herringbone. What are you calling this? Crosshatch?
Yeah, I call it
crosshatch. Well, you would know better because you know color and trim
and
better than me. Oh, let's look
good.
Back. Does Karen look good with her... her own fitted luggage from her Genesis to carry on.
Hollywood lifestyle.
Yeah.
Luggage and
this. I don't think that would look good on EVA though.
Yeah. This thing is a lock for the luggage. Magnetically will lock into your luggage.
Okay.
So when you're driving, you'll lock the luggage
and
safely.
And then I see. Now, you've put two bucket seats with a console back there and a divider. I don't see this coming to production. It's beautiful. I would love a car with this.
So the front bridge console, dashboard, as I explained to you, is also reversible. So this is another bridge in the back.
Oh, so it's like you've closed it. You've got bookends.
Yeah, so like a cradle of rare seat.
So it's you've got the cross hatch all the way around.
Right, yeah.
And it basically closes off the interior. Better way to put
so
it,
you
cradle.
Feel safe and comfortable.
Oh, look at these spotlights up here.
This is supposed to be a hand gesture.
Yeah. You know, I'm getting a lot of comments coming in, and everybody's going on and on and on about you got to build this, you got to build this, you got to build this.
We are.
But you are going to build it.
Yeah, told everyone we are.
So you guys, if you didn't see the beginning of this broadcast, Brad told us that this is actually in reverse. You worked on the real car first, and now you're showing, then you came up with a concept after the fact, which is different. It's usually the other way around. Okay. Anything else you want to show us about the interior?
The wood.
This is repeated from the floor.
Yeah, so everything is like really premium detail and also modern. Almost feel like home, away from home, like dual feeling.
It is a sanctuary, I'll definitely give you that.
I love it.
I'd love to see at least 60 to 70% of those details make it to the real car.
Oh yeah, we are pushing for it.
Anything, can you tell it, like Brad told us the wheels are... we'll make it to the real car, at least just a slightly smaller version.
Yes.
Is there any details on the interior you know for a fact is going to make it to the real car?
The dashboard, the design language, how simple it is.
So that bridge type thing?
That bridge, yeah.
Do you see any of those textures making it to the...
Yes, we're going to push forward. Because we got amazing feedback on the texture. Everyone loved the texture.
Yeah.
Like Colin and Trim Design did an amazing job on this car.
They really did. Yeah.
So I'm going to tell them the feedback and then we're going to fight for this material to production.
Anything else you want to show us about the car on the inside?
So do you see the bridge element? It's also on the back of the seat.
So it's repeated on the seat,
And it's cradled the screen behind it.
So it's like a tablet.
Yes, and they go up and down.
That's pretty cool.
So yeah, every design element talking with each other is very harmonious. Look.
This might be the best we can get for the back seat. I don't know if they can open up the door. These cars, to give you an idea, guys, this is these cars are kind of like China dolls. They're very delicate. They're held together by chewing gum and spit, so you don't really want to screw with them too much because they don't.
It's a show car.
It's a show car. They go a max of 5 miles an hour.
Right.
Actually, I drove one. I drove the curb. The one I built. Let me drive it. Yeah.
They'll never let me drive it. They're like,
stick with me, and I'll tell you what. We'll drive
this
together.
Take me for a ride.
Okay,
for
we're gonna
trip.
Do that.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to show us?
One last thing. We want to make each driver and passenger feel special. So this design here in the back of the headrest, it's like a crown, like a king crown. So you really feel like you are in control of the car. They really make you feel special.
You're treating everybody like royalty.
Yes.
I get it.
Thank
okay.
You.
Karen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Everybody say thank you to Karen.
I'll see you guys next time.
Okay, we're going to come to your studio. Come here, John.
Okay.
Brad, come here. That's Christine. Say hi, Christine. That's Christine.
Hi.
She's behind the scenes. She doesn't like being on camera. Okay.
Yeah.
This is the whole team. Let's get the whole team in there. Whole team. Whole team. Okay, this is actually not the whole team. We're missing Andrew, right?
Andrew, Tony, Taryn.
Okay, so here's what we're going to do. So first things first, you guys know you've been on the show many times before. I like to end the episodes by asking a question, but this is your car, so I'm going to open up the question to you to ask the audience. What do you want to know from the audience about the car? You can solicit feedback, you can tell them anything you want, but they're very vocal. And they would love to provide you feedback. So what would you like to know? You got questions?
What show car do you want to see next from us?
That's a damn good question. Yeah. So for the avoidance of doubt, type of show car or?
Yeah, what vehicle type?
What vehicle type?
To do?
Okay.
Yeah.
John, do you have a question?
What do you think of our vision moving forward for the SUV?
So specifically where this is going. And then Karen, do you have a question?
I have one for the center console. The inlay metal bar, when you swipe up and down to control the navigation screen, how do you guys like that gesture?
Okay, that's a very good question as well. So let's recap. For Brad, to answer Brad's question, we want to know what type of concept car do you want to see next from the Genesis brand?
Yep.
And that, to answer the question, let us know in the comments below or via our social media, MotoManTV, one word, MotoManTV, one word. And then John, who is the, we're going to congratulate you once again for being the big boss now, having his own studio. Well, you are the big boss. Seriously, the guy's being
part of the leadership.
All of these people, they're ridiculously modest. You have no idea how talented these designers are. I knew this kid was going places. One of these days, he's going to be running his own studio. He already runs his own studio. And she's going to take over the world, and these two are going to work for her.
Yeah.
Probably.
Pretty much. So, congratulations to you again. I really am excited for you.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
And his question is, what do you think of the vision of, basically the design direction of Genesis?
The concept, yeah.
What do you like? What do you don't like? Share us in the comments below or via our social media, MotoManTV, all one word. And then the last question is from Karen. And Karen's question is, how do you like the UX of the slider control for all of the infotainment?
Right.
Again, comments below or via our social media, MotoManTV, all one word, MotoManTV, all one word, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And with that, I'm going to leave you with two things. Click subscribe and notifications on YouTube. I know they're idiots and they've ruined the whole subscription module. They're just, even these guys were complaining to me. They're like, they don't get notified of my episodes anymore. Even Karen, who I just met, she said I was famous, but I'm not anymore because the subscriptions don't work. And number two, here's a fun fact. Karen, I mean, no, Christine, come here.
I have to grab John.
No, come here for a minute.
I'm sorry.
One more thing. Here's the fun fact. Christine and I nearly got killed getting fried chicken in the South.
That is a true story. That's a true story. And with that, I'm grabbing John.
Okay.
Krsteski.
Bye.
Okay.
See you guys in about 15 minutes for the next live broadcast. Say goodbye to Brad.
Have a lovely day, guys.
Say goodbye to Karen. And bye, Kamala, Brad's wife.
That's right.